Joining us, Chris Mason, the BBC political editor, has confirmed that Boris Johnson is going to step down. We expect a statement from the Prime Minister today. He will serve as Prime Minister until a successor is elected in the autumn, if the Conservative Party members, of course, and the MPs allow him to stay on until the autumn. Of course, there needs to be now a Conservative Party election for the new leader. It's expected there will be a very big field. We saw a letter from Nadeem Zahawi published on Twitter today calling for the Prime Minister to step down. Boris Johnson has seen the scale of opposition against him and he has now agreed to resign. Well, of course, it had been incredibly febrile in the last 24 hours and it was clear that this was only moving in one direction. That came after a very senior Foreign Office official contradicted the Prime Minister, saying effectively he had been dishonest about a very serious sexual assault allegation against a member of the Prime Minister's government. That whole scandal was just the latest in a stream of scandals that has dogged the Prime Minister after Partygate, criticism about his own sense of honesty and integrity, the heart of the criticism about his character, something that even his allies accepted couldn't be fixed by new policy announcements, arguments over tax, arguments about how to address the very urgent questions on the cost of living that are only set to escalate in the next few months, and a real sense of policy drift with the Conservative government as Boris Johnson has been buffeted over and over again by crises seem to be of his own making. Well, of course, we have had a stream of resignations, over 50, 54, 55 resignations or more. And of course, we've also had the interventions today from Nadeem Zahawi, who has described himself as a friend of 30 years, saying that he privately counseled the Prime Minister to step down yesterday, but today has gone public with that call. And Michelle Donnellan, the Education Minister, newly appointed only yesterday, again resigning. It looks chaotic. Critics of the Conservative Party in the opposition, of course, say that the whole party, the whole Tory party, has been corrupted by what is going on by the leadership of Boris Johnson. We're expecting, though, now the Prime Minister to come out at some point here in Downing Street and make a statement. It's been reported, but you can't confirm it, that the Prime Minister spoke to Graham Brady, who is the chairman of the 1922 Backbench Committee, and confirmed that he had pondered events and realised basically that the game was up. And that became apparent because with the stream of resignations, the stream of withdrawal of support from the backbenchers, it was clear that Boris Johnson basically did not have the confidence of his own party. And although we don't have a written constitution, no Prime Minister can stay in office when they cannot get the full backing of their party because they can't get the backing of Parliament. We also heard a number of criticisms from former ministers today saying they feared this was a Trump-style challenge to the Constitution, someone trying to stay in office beyond the time that they had any legitimacy to do so. Those are very, very serious charges, some people even questioning whether Boris Johnson's judgment was completely sound, given the fact that he had not seen the scale of opposition and stepped down already. Well, it seems that today, this morning, that moment has finally come. This is the man, of course, who delivered Brexit for this country, came into power under extraordinary circumstances. Brexit is still a very divisive question. The cost of living, the war in Ukraine, the pandemic have all been huge issues for Boris Johnson to deal with. There's been a lot of controversy around many of his judgments, even on some of those very, very big questions.